My Heritage, everyone know My Heritage? Amazing company, doing amazing stuff. A good friend of mine, Aaron, is the VP marketing there. And they got themselves on Fox News. It started a month ago and they managed to get it again this week. One of their new services is My Heritage DNA, which is one of those cheek swab things. You put it in a box, you send it off, and then you can get all of the data about your DNA and where you come from. They're doing a lot of performance. They're trying to promote this online. They've got competition. And they managed to get a slot on the Fox, one of the Fox programs, which is internet only. So not like the biggest deal, but a group of them on the sofa, Aaron was there with them, talking about it, and gave them each on the couch their own kit, and they swapped themselves on the couch, and then they took the boxes off. They were so interested in the results, they decided the results was worth actually putting live on television on one of the shows that was there, so obviously a much bigger audience. And that's where, you know, this lady and many other similar looking Fox News presenters had their DNA revealed to the rest of the world, you know, seeing, you know, 68% from North and West Europe, 29% Scandinavian, 1.6% Middle Eastern, and of course that everyone has a little bit of Sierra Leonean in them. So maybe that's the margin of error, I don't know. An amazing bit of PR of like getting onto that spot, and I tried to force Aaron to actually give me the real numbers that I could share in his forum of what that did to their sales, and he refused, in a private company, blah, blah, blah. But basically, bottom line was, they had sold more of these, because it was just you had to go online and order it, they sold more of this kit in that one day than they had done in several months beforehand. So when PR can work, you know, to drive customer growth, it can work amazingly. These sorts of things don't always come around. I remember in my supermarket days when early on we managed to get ourselves on the sofa on one of the morning programs, the traffic, the Google Analytics exploded. So it really is possible to make, you know, a massive difference with one of these things. But you can't build a PR program around these things. If you can do it once in a while, it's great, but it's not, you know, this will die down. Like the impact of this is probably dead already. The next time they'll be able to get something as big, as great as Fox Live is going to be a while, they're going to have to build something up which is across the board. And that's what I try and share now. Grabbing the attention of investors is another point. Even when you've just done a round of investment, we're a proud Carmel company, but you're all often looking for that next round of investment, even when you don't know when it's going to be and how big it's going to be. So if you're continuously getting yourselves in the news and investors are going to see it, it's going to be useful for when that time comes around. And that time often does come around. Yeah, absolutely. And influencers as well. This was a really good one for us in the Philippines. This guy's called Jonathan Yabut, who was the winner of the Apprentice Asia. The Apprentice Asia was like pan-Asian. They didn't just have it in one country. The Donald Trump of it was Tony Fernandez. Anyone know him? I think he's the Air Malaysia CEO. He's like a colorful character. He owns a football club in England as well. So he was the host. Jonathan Yabut was this 20-something-year-old that won it. He got hired to work for Air Malaysia. He was there for about a year and then quit because he couldn't. He was an entrepreneur at heart and just couldn't fit in a role stuck in an Air Asia office. And we kind of connected with him online. He saw some of the stuff we were doing in Payoneer. And then, you know, things like this, thank you, Payoneer, I just finished, and we invited him to a conference, he came along, we really built him up, then we started to get him to do other things, we got him to write white papers for us, and we really got him as kind of a brand ambassador for us, but it really started through, you know, him seeing us in the headlines in the Philippines, and seeing this American company. You know, bear in mind, we're kind of compared to PayPal in many cases, or compared to banks, and they cannot believe sometimes when the company is coming to them, when the executives of the company are organizing events, attending them, meeting customers, talking to the press, going on television. They came to the Philippines, they really care about us, and then influencers, you know, come and join you too. The other one, I don't know how much of you get pressure from HR, I certainly do from time to time. It's a thing, like you've got to hire, it's a competitive landscape. Anyone who's in Israel trying to hire developers, it's super competitive. So it becomes actual part, one of our PR goals, I don't know if it is for you, is also building up the profile of the company for recruitment. In the US, in our US office, we spend a load on recruitment consultants, and in Israel we spend a lot less because there's a lot more awareness of Payoneer and a lot more friend bring a friend. So, you know, trying to, you know, build up the name of the company, even if they don't hear, even if, and I interviewed a guy a few days ago that admitted he hadn't heard of Payoneer before, but when the when I saw the ad and then I Googled Payoneer and I looked in and Google News, which is what so many people looking for a job will do, is like, okay, it sounds interesting job, but I don't know who this company is, let's see what, and they they find a Google News page which doesn't just have a clipping from 2 years ago when you raised money, then they actually feel, wow, this is really interesting. Stuff's happening at this company. So you can really make a difference there.